time to rewind back to 1995 when we were nothing. Walking through the streets of Boston, no one listening, no one caring about the empty rooms we played. Until they all showed up one day, then we took the stage and everything changed. Turn that shit up louder.
For the fourth race of the season for the Mountain Dew Voltage Cup Series, we are here at Auto Club for 38 laps of racing. On the front row is going to be Brenda Harrell and Michael Amato, and in row two is Samuel York and Stephanie Vanas. Benjamin Tilton in points leader, I believe, Hayden Bergeron in row three, Michael Parker, Kate Rogers in row four, and Benjamin Dion and Steve Cavallo in row five. Let's go down trackside for the starting command. Drivers, start your engines. Forty-two drivers, 38 laps of action, probably going to be a few cautions. Pit strategy, as we saw that in the truck race, fuel became an issue. Who will win it today, and will we get a repeat winner right now? Get ready to go, green flag action. We have seen two Chevys and a Dodge win. Ford nor Toyota have visited victory lane yet this season. Also, last season after four races, or the first two seasons after four races, we have hit at least one two-time race winner. Will that happen today? Your candidates are Ken Vieira, Logan Scott, and Scott Greene. Green flag is out, and we are underway at Auto Club. So the racing is already getting dicey. Brenda Harrell and then Samuel York still looking for that first winning cup. He has not run in trucks or any other series. He's a career cup driver, and he is showing it right now with his good starting spot. Benjamin Tilton looking for his first win in the series since Martinville of season one. Now, they wrecked on lap one in trucks. Are they going to do that here today? It does not look like they will wreck on in cup, but Brenda Harrell with a huge lead right now. Benjamin Dion on the bottom, and our part-time drivers for today's race, Eric Carolla, Logan York, and Cindy Vieira, who won the event for the part-timers, as now here comes Eric Carolla along with Gene Harrell. Kate Rogers on the bottom in the back here. So far, Brenda Harrell staying strong, trying to get her first win since Talladega, which was last season. They have been doing a good job of keeping it clean. The only real rule for a wreck is if you go five wide. And we'll see if any of our last winners, Benjamin Dion and Zachary Rogers, were the winners from last year, as Michael Beeson is coming up to the front. As it looks like a challenge to the lead will be made now, going through three and four on lap three. Things are starting to get a little dicey up here. There's Cindy Vieira, who won the part-timers race. And they are getting dicey. Now the 56 of Cody Russell to the bottom. And we did have a bit of a big wreck in the finale here last season, as now they are really scraping the wall, and Cody Russell's going to get spun out. Cindy Vieira's involved. Benjamin Tilton, Brenda Harrell, and we got another wreck up here. That's Eric Carolla, and I think that was Amato and Cavanero that got into it. Leading it to the line will be Michael Beeson. Second is Tony Vieira. Third, Nathan Rogers. Fourth, Peyton Goodwin. And fifth will be Austin Alves. As we will most likely see the first pit stops of the day, but it seems we had two separate incidents. Eric Carolla was involved in one. Cody Russell, Brenda Harrell, Benjamin Tilton, Michael Amato, Alan Cavanero, Benjamin Dion, and Cindy Vieira, and there might... Nope. So, a few cars involved. Eric Carolla looks like he's done, and I think Cody Russell will be too. We pretty much saw what happened to the first wreck, but I'm curious to what happened to get Eric Carolla involved. as there are most likely going to be a few more retirees. Actually, Eric Carolla, they're trying to fix his damage, but he might fall a lap down here. If that light turns red, Eric Carolla will be stuck behind the pace car. Anyway, while pit stops commence, let's take you to see what happened to the 4 car. Well, up on the top of the screen, you see they try to go 5 wide for the lead almost, and that's just not going to work. And how does the 4 get involved in all this? So they're going to wreck right there. And it looks like everybody's just going to start squeezing. And it looks like the 4 came down and the 54 went up, and that's how the 33, the 4, and then the 24 get involved. So that's how that happened. So tough break for maybe the 4. And Cody Russell's bad luck continuing here today at Auto Club. Let's take you to the restart. Alright, as we get ready to go back racing, Michael Beeson is the race leader. Second, Samuel York. Third, Kate Rogers. Fourth is Gene Arala. Fifth, Nolan Bergeron. Sixth, Stephanie Vinales. Seventh, Nathan Rogers. Eighth, Michael Parker. Ninth, Austin House. And tenth is Hayden Bergeron. Only car out of the race is the 56 of Cody Russell. Eric Carolla and Benjamin Dion are both a lap down. 8 laps complete. We will have 30 remaining. And will it be like the truck race? Can they keep it green? A little bit of a voice crack there on my part. We'll see. Green flag is back out. We are back on the way. And to me, it looks like the 4 is slower than the 33. Kate Rogers may be trying to get the AAA car here in at to the winner at Auto Club. And they've already wrecked. And that was probably because of the slow cars. We'll check that out after. But as for now, Michael Beeson looking to hold the lead. Going back to the line. It looks like the 4 and the 33 just got into it because they were both so slow. Right now, it looks like Beeson has it. And Michael Beeson will lead it back to the line. Gene Harala second. Third will be Nolan Bergeron. Fourth, Kate Rogers. And fifth will be Samuel York. Jim Morton with heavy damage. Tony Vieira is going to be out of the race, it seems. Eric Carolla with more damage. Hayden Bergeron, the points leader, has damage. And I think that might be all. But Jim Morton, definitely out of the race. So let's take you to see what caused our second caution of the day. Alright, so coming into turn one, looks like Eric thinks he was clear. The 23 thought he was too, and they're just going to get into it. This is going to take out 11th and 8th place, and then Tony Vieira just had nowhere to go. So they all get involved. It looks like the 23 and the 71 got the worst of it, along with the 4. The 19 didn't really get that much damage. Amato does slice the 23 a little. That was it. I would say the 23, 71, and the 4 took the hardest hits. We'll see if Hayden Bergeron stays in the race or not. Let's take you to the restart. Ready to go back green. Tony Vieira, Jim Morton, and thankfully Eric Carolla now out of the race because his damage would have caused more problems. So only Benjamin Dion, only lap car lap down. Top 10 rundown now. Kate Rogers leads. Second, Gene Arala. Third, Austin House. Fourth, Nolan Bergeron. Fifth, Michael Beeson. Sixth, Stephanie Vinales. Seventh, James Morton. Eighth, Karen Vieira. Ninth, Samuel York. Tenth is Nathan Rogers. So Ford trying to get their first win of the season at one of their home tracks. Owner of Team Penske used to own this track. Now it's owned by Auto Club. And that's the sponsor on the 22. As the green flag waves, we have 25 laps to go. Can they try to keep it green here for a little while? And that 33 car doesn't seem to be causing much of a problem to me. Kate Rogers going to take the lead, or has the lead, I should say. Nolan Bergeron trying to find his way up here, get another win for Evernham. But Ford's up here. Kate Rogers, Austin Alves looking for their first wins of the season. As Gene Harala, we have not seen a rookie win yet this season, and it would be amazing to have one win. We've got a lot of them. So Gene Harala will take the race lead as we actually can complete a lap now. Let's try to go for 5 laps of green flag runs, guys. As now Nolan Bergeron is looking for the race lead. James Morton on the bottom, another rookie to talk about. Jim's son, who's not racing on the same team as he is, racing for the famed Hendrick Motorsports, looking to get his first win. His father, Jim, already has 3 in his career, so James is a little behind, but Nolan Bergeron looking for the race lead. As we've got our branch off cars here, Hayden Bergeron is slow, Cindy Vieira, Alan Cavanero, Michael Amato, Benjamin Tilton, Brenda Harala, Benjamin Dion. But it looks like the 42, 11, and 24, they appear to be up to speed, but they lost the pack. As back up to the front, Zachary Rogers making his way up to the front now, but Gene Harala in command. Here comes Adam Rogers, a driver that hasn't won a race yet in his career, who made the chase last season, looking for his first career victory. Nathan Rogers, another driver, looking for his first win of his career, driving for a new team, Extreme Motorsport. Allison Rogers, a teammate at that team, moving up here, also his sister. And they're getting dicey, 4 wide for the race lead. And it's going to be Allison Rogers at the line. That would have been a classic finish. As we have made it about 5 laps now. Green flag, and I'm going to jinx us. I think I'm going to jinx us. Steve Cavallo making his way to the lead. He has won here before, looking for his 7th career victory. Franklin Ayers on the bottom. Here comes Samuel York, looking for his first career win. And I think pit stops are starting to begin. Yes, Michael Santos is going in. They're going to wreck. Adam Rogers is involved. Caution will be out as somebody dove the pit road. They should be okay, though. They'll get back up in front. But that was a huge, huge wreck. We got the big one on our hands. Peyton Goodwin is smoking. Kate Rogers and Michael Parker and some others made the dive to pit road. Hayden Bergeron made the dive to pit road, but I saw the 68 is smoking. Gene Harala was involved. Adam Rogers was involved. I'm thinking Michael Jenkins might have gotten a piece of it. It looked like essentially a big wreck, and oh man, are we getting strategy? Everybody should have the pit. No, people are just messing up who's supposed to be going where. And there might be some strategy playing, actually. Some drivers might be wanting to pit a lap later. That might be the case. They're trying to pit a lap later. Samuel York leads him down. Let's see what caused the 3rd caution of the day. And here we go. And it looks like the 2 just drives the double steer up into the 99 and the 27. And look at the 99. He hit the wall. And there's a ton of smoke. And it looks like everybody was able to hit the brakes. Oh, Vinas gets into it. And this might be where Jenkins gets into it a little bit here. So it was actually not that big of a wreck. What happened to the 19 car, though? It looks like Hayden Bergeron might have had a separate deal or he was just pitting. But a lot of drivers did a good job to get through there. Beeson with some back-end damage. Tough break for Peyton Goodwin and Adam Rogers, though. Let's take you to the restart. Ready to go back green. Following drivers now out of the race. Peyton Goodwin, Gene Harala, and Hayden Bergeron had an issue. So we have 35 cars in the race. Only the 33 is a lap down. Top 10 rundown now. 3 cars stayed out. 4 cars, actually. Franklin Ayers leads. James Morton second. Logan Scott third. Alan Cavanero fourth. Those 4 stayed out. Then of the cars that pit, Michael Santos 5th, Michael Naylor 6th, Michael Parker 7th, Nico Tringale 8th, Samuel York 9th, and 10th is Steve Cavallo. And it looks like the 78 and the 5 just ran out of gas. So they are going to pit. And that could be a problem. The 88 has not pit yet. nor the 54. And the 54 just ran out of gas. And the 88 just ran out of gas. Oh, don't wreck. Don't wreck. And they just wrecked. Caution's going to be out. Oh, and that's the 22 car. Yep. That is why you're supposed to pit. Michael Santos will assume the lead. Oh my gosh, bunch of morons. And look who's up here, Nico Tringali, the defending champion, has not done that well yet this season, and he's looking for a win here at this track, and it looks like Michael Santos will lead it back to the line. James Morton, Frank Linares are going to come out of the pit. They are going to be laps down. Looks like Tilton's day is done. Kevin Harrow's out of gas, and he's over here, and there they go. You have got to be kidding me. You're not even supposed to be on the apron. Why did you go on the apron? And Nico Tringali just ruined his day. Idiot. There's Logan Scott on the bottom. Samuel York has damage. You've got to be kidding me, guys. He's on the apron. Don't go on the apron. You're under caution. Like, they're mad at him for holding him up. Now Karen Vieira has damage. Austin Ells, Brendan Harala are done. Just a bunch of stupidity right here. Can't believe it. Alright, let's see what happened to this caution here. Alright, like, he's going low. Go high. You've got four lanes of racing, and they did this. There's Tilton, there's Alves. There's Kate Rogers getting involved. Brenda Harrell is going to slam the 22 car. And it looks like Logan York's barely going to make that by. So they did all that. There's Logan Scott nicking the wall. So that's going to end their days. Now, what the hell were they thinking coming back? And there's the 5 and the 78 who ran out of gas. Look at the 44 car here. He's got a good run. He's up front. And what does he do? This is just ridiculous. There's the car. He's at the bottom of the racetrack. And you're gonna try to go underneath him to get by. And he was coming down. You've just got to be kidding me. The 45. The 32. There they are ruined. And the 32. 44. 45. They're just ruined. And I know the 44 was going low. Because the 54. His teammate wasn't down there yet. I'm sorry, but this 5-point penalties to the 44 and the 54, because it's just, you just stupid move. The 54, 44 was going super fast on a flat lane, and you don't do that. And then the 54, cars are going to try to go under you. Why did you move down to the apron? You spot up. I'm sorry, it's just going to be a 5-point penalty to each driver. You can complain all you want, but I saw it. The 54 moved down after his own team owner was going by him, trying to go by him. Both stupid moves. The 44 should have slowed down enough by then. So, both of you are going to get 5-point penalties. I'm sorry, that's just the way it's going to be. Let's get you back to the green flag. Go green before we announce who's out of the race. The cup board looked over the incident, and upon looking at both views, Nico Tringali will not be penalized, but the 54 will be getting a 5-point penalty for LePaging his team owner along with some other drivers. So 5-point penalty for the 54, Alan Cavanero. Cars out of the race, Benjamin Tilton, Alan Cavanero. Austin Isles, Brenda Harala, Logan York, Samuel York, and Karen Vieira. Two laps down is Logan Scott, and one lap down, Dion, James Morton, and Frank Linares. Top 10 rundown, Michael Santos, Peter Sands, Nolan Bergeron, Steve Cavallo, Robert Rogers, Michael Naylor, Allison Rogers, Carol Morton, Zachary Rogers, and Michael Beeson. 11 laps to go. Can we keep it green? There's probably going to be one more pit stop. Michael Santos trying to get his third career victory. And James Morton, who is a lap down, already diving to the bottom. Just a reminder quickly, he had the 5 and the 78 are a lap down. Also, a notice that Nico Tringale is still in the race, so upon hearing he will not be penalized 5 points, he will still be going up for a solid finish. It's Robert Rogers on the bottom, going to look for the race lead here. Taking the lead, coming to 10 to go. Robert Rogers in front. Michael Santos, second, third. Peter Sands, fourth. Michael Naylor. Carol Morton rounding out the top 5. It's now Michael Naylor looking for the race lead. And these drivers up here, some of them have not won a race yet in their career, as they have kind of split the pack here. Robert Rogers still leading. Carol Morton won a race last season when she was doing the part-timers, and that is how she actually got into the series for a full-time ride. And there, pit stops again. We are getting pit stops here. Green flag. People making their last stops. Sands, Nolan Bergeron, Carnero, Kate Rogers, Spinaz, Cindy Vieira. So it looks like they could do it the peaceful way, as Michael Naylor will be taking the race lead. We've only got 4 drivers up here. Zachary Rogers back here into 5th. Steve Cavallo in 6th, who has won here before. Who's going to make their pit stop this time by? Looks like the 2 and the 20 are coming down. And somebody just got spun out. No caution. Allison Rogers got spun out. No caution. We are still green. She will have to continue now out of. So no caution waves. Michael Naylor, Carol Morton still in the top 2 spots here. The 47 will be coming to pit road. Here comes Michael Naylor. So the 5 and the 78 will stay out. We'll see where they come around when the other drivers come out. Nathan Rogers staying out. Ryan Shea. Others, Zachary Rogers down. Michael Beeson and Nico Tringale down. Here's Peter Sands. Looks like he got a really good stop. As here's James Morton and Frank Linares. Now back on the lead lap. They are coming to pit though this time. Final pit stops of the day. Nathan Rogers is going to stretch it one more lap. It looks like as Shea's coming down, Amato stays out. Parker stays out. Quiet. No. Robert Rogers comes out ahead of Peter Sands. So 2 drivers looking for their first career victories. Here come the other drivers out. There is Michael Naylor. Let's see where these. We've got 3 drivers. 4 drivers, actually. We haven't pit yet. Here comes Nathan Rogers. Amato. Parker. Logan Scott might have one more stop left. There's Michael Naylor, actually comes out as the race leader. And Carol Morton, then Robert Rogers, Peter Sands, and Zachary Rogers. As Michael Naylor will take the race lead for now, and we'll see if those other drivers behind them have a shot here. They have the draft. Frank Linares coming out from his final stop, along with others. As these guys are still cycling around, and Nathan Rogers is still considered the race leader. So I thought Naylor was the leader. Yep, those drivers are coming back on the lead lap. And it looks like Nathan Rogers, it looks like staying out, could be a benefactor. Coming to 4 laps remaining, Ryan Shea is in second. Looks like it's going to be between the 89 and the 15. So we have come to 4 laps to go. Ryan Shea looking for his first win of the season, looking to get Toyota in victory lane. As he will make the pass for the moment. Can the 10 get up front? Here's Peter Sands, Robert Rogers, Kieran Morton, Zachary Rogers up to 7th. 8th is Michael Amato. 9th, John Linares. And 10th, Michael Parker. Now Michael Santos looking for 10th. Side-by-side action coming to 3 laps to go. And that could very well be how the finish looks. Nathan Rogers to the point for now. And this side-by-side racing helps the 10 car. Other drivers here trying to make it back up, and they're just so far away right now. But they're liking this side-by-side action. Oh, man. Ryan Shea now back to the front. And this looks like it's going to go back and forth for a while. 2 laps to go. And how much ground did they gain? They're not gaining that much. Pretty much, it's going to be the 15 or the 89 here. Now Nathan Rogers to the bottom. Ryan Shea getting a little run off the corner. Coming to the white flag. Can Nathan Rogers make Auto Club winners streak? No. Crap. Doing a fail here. No other manufacturer besides Chevy. Season 1 was Cavallo in a Chevy. Season 2, Rogers and Dion in Chevys. Toyota looking to break the streak. Can Nathan Rogers get a run? Nathan Rogers getting a run. Can he make a move to the bottom? Or does Ryan Shea have this in his grasp? Here comes Nathan Rogers! Coming to the checkered flag! Side by side, it's gonna be Ryan Shea! Ryan Shea gets Toyota's first win of the season! What a close finish that was! Nathan Rogers had made it to the bottom a little sooner, he might have had it. That is probably the closest finish of the season. Congratulations to Ryan Shea on getting his first win of the year. We will see you guys for the Martinsville races. See you guys soon.